Alright, mga kabiba, Max subscribers, thank you for the 2.6k view subscribers na na-receive ko within the day. So I am humbly obliged to review Ikaw Lang Ang Mahal kasi mahal na mahal ko kayong mga viewers ko. And here is my review of, I think it could be one of Kylie Versoza's best performance. It could be one of Cara Gonzales' best performance. And it's all because of this guy, Zanjoe Marudo. And this is Ikaw Lang Ang Mahal. Wala siyang password sa Vivamax. So it is implied na walang bold dito. But I can assure you, it has, what, six intercourse scenes. So yeah, this is a mature movie. So ingat na lang sa mga bata na baka magbukas ng Vivamax sa kanilang browser at mapanood to. Kasi you can say, walang password to. So, libreng-libre to na ma-access sa mga bata. Baka ma-patch to ng Viva in the future. But I'm just warning for those adults sa may mga kids na piniprevent yung mga bata na manood ng mga ganitong klaseng pelikula. Like, subscribe, and share the video if you can. At nakita nyo ang bunga ng ating paghihirap. We got 49,000 views on my last video. With the latest episode of Scandalo 6, we will be reviewing Scandalo 7 later, which is the death of Trent. And yeah, today we are going to be reviewing Ikaw Lang Ang Mahal. So what can I say about this movie? That's the same premise as The Wife, which also stars Cara Gonzales, and Cara Gonzales stars as yung kabit nung leading man with the parallelism ng The Wife, si Diego Lozaga. Dito naman si Zanjoe Marudo. Zanjoe Marudo is Andrei, a documentarist. So he traveled to Sagada to film a documentary on the national artists there, like yung uncle ni Kylie Versoza, who is played by Joel Torres, Butch. We got Patring, who is a painter, and we got the other uncle ni Kylie Versoza, who is like a interpretative artist. So yun yung parang mission ni Andrei papunta sa Sagada. Kylie plays as a sexy writer named Lira, talented writer named Lira, a beautiful writer named Lira. Lira as in yung Lira sa Encantadia, that Lira. So, unang eksena pa lang, we're seeing this is a different side of Kylie Versoza. This is much more mature, and it is noteworthy to considering that this Kylie Versoza is little less protected than most of her roles in previous films. To the point na meron siyang nudity dito. Okay, we don't see any of her nips. So, we're not gonna have a channel tomorrow, aren't we? We don't see any of her nips. Those are well protected. But you can see her ass, you can see her body, and you can see a boob area. So, that's how I think the comfort ni Kylie na maghubad ngayon has evolved. And I think that elevated the movie. The movie itself has a good premise. You got a documentarist, he falls in love with a girl, and he meets two girls who are really, really slutty. At gusto which is like the conflict nung storya na to. So the first girl that he met is Ingrid, who is also a director, and she is played by Cara Gonzales. Now, I have criticized Cara before in this channel, but my God, I say this is the film that she needed to elevate her standing on the Vivamax hierarchy. Maganda yung ano, para tinago yung weakness ni Cara dito in terms of her sex, and she can't act, so they made her scene simple. Na she's a woman, she preys on her victim, she's the predator, and they had sex, and that's like that. That's the thing. Maikli lang ang mga eksena ni Cara dito, but it was worth it. It was good. It was satisfying. It was hot. It was steamy. It was passionate, and I like that. I think they've the director has figured out the strength si Cara. So I'm gonna give my flowers to him. Kudos to Stephen A. Smith sa Termino. I'm gonna give my flowers to the director for elevating Cara Gonzales, who I consider as the Baron Corbin ng Vivamax. So this is the welcome to the Balay fuck body niya, naging ano niya, parang fubo ni ano ni Andrei si Ingrid. So fubo niya yun. We also got the Butch, who is played by Joel Torre, a reluctant. So what happens here is nabangga ni Zanjoe si ay ni Andrei si Lira. That's how they met, and Lira happens to be the niece of Butch, and this is how Lira connected Butch to Andrei for their documentary. In the una pa lang reluctant si Butch na magpa-interview, but in the end nagpa-interview siya. He is a naturalist, so he showed the nature, he toured Zanjoe while Zanjoe is filming. Zanjoe on Zanjoe dito, we should have been toured with Andrei after that. So we went to, from there, Lira and Andrei developed a relationship. They had a one-night stand sa bahay ni Lira. And there was no intimate feelings like there, but there was a spark in chemistry. Then there's another deal that since Butch wants Andrei to prove himself worthy to interview Butch, he made an arrangement for Andrei and the painter there named Patring. Patring is a slutty painter na she allowed persons to interview her as long as she have sex with them. And that's what happens with Andrei and Patring. They had sex. This is soggy tits. They did a good job making Patring as hateable as a character. She has sloppy tits and she has nipples made of raisins. And I can't believe Andrei pinatulan yun. Kylie showed up because Lira showed up during the intercourse scene. And that is assuming na sinabi kasi ni Lira babalik siya within 3 hours. So Andrei and Patring had intercourse for like 3 hours. That's pretty long for soggy tits, di ba? Now, ito yung first fracture sa relationship, and we go to an arc where Andrei tries to apologize to Lira. And then there's the tease of Cara again, so they had, as a fubu, they had intercourse in the hallway. This is a funny scene kasi it's a small dim hallway at hindi sila nakikita ng mga ka-room nila sa balay. So, I don't know how that worked, but sure, whatever. Good job, Cara. Man, this, ayun. In the end, naging sila ni, ano, ni Lira. And they managed to dig some dirt with Patring by Andrei interviewing Lira's other uncle, played by Ronnie Lazaro, which kind of reveals how dirty is the painter works, actually. In the end, there was a mini celebration ng love ni, ano, ng dalawa. And then yung dalawang babae na kinanyod ni Andrei, binalikan siya, which led to Lira being disappointed and leaving Andrei. This ends with the ending. Ito yung ending na hinanap ni Andrei si Lira throughout Baguio, throughout Sagada. And the ending, nagkita sila sa tuktok ng bundok, but this is like a metaphor. If I'm going to interpret it, nagpakamatay si Lira. That's just it. Kasi if you're looking at the reflection or parang ano, it seems that yung voice over na nangyari sa dulo ng pelikula to is coming from a suicide note. And yun yung binabasa ni Andre. It could be that or it could be one of yung mga obra ni Lira because Lira is a writer. But it does sounds like a suicide note, and that is how yung parang metaphysical body ni Lira is communicating with Andrei in the afterlife. So, yeah, Andrei didn't cut on with Lira when she left. It's either she is presumed dead. So, yeah. This is Kylie's best work, to be honest. She is now comfortable with more mature roles. I like Cara here. I think yung negative dito is the soggy tits. So, I'm giving this on the same tier as the wife even though it has more nudity than The Wife. I think this is a good movie, to be honest. And yeah, kung hindi kayo mahilig sa bold, sige, you can give it a shot to watch it over the weekend. But kung gusto niyo hanap yung kwento, I think this is one of the rare Vivamax movies that you can possibly watch. So that is me, Harriet. I should go.